The story of Blackbird is basically the meeting of two people who haven't seen each other in 15 years. And the circumstances are they had a love affair 15 years ago. When my character was 12 years old, your character was 40.
We don't really think of that kind of situation as being normal, but sadly I think it is. This is a really normal story to be telling. Which is also why I think it's important.
Because of something that happened to her at a very young age, in a very vulnerable age, she has had to carry around this weight and this conflict of who she is and what the world is as a result of what's happened to her. And that's why I think Una is such a great character, is she kind of lifts that struggle. And throughout the show, we get to see her reveal a little bit more of that bit by bit, and you get to understand how deep these scars go.
At this point, he doesn't want to see Una. He wants to pretend it never happened. He actually says it's the biggest, most stupid mistake he's ever made. Ray's all about starting over. He acknowledges that he did make an error. But the play really talks about, do people, when they do make a horrific error in life, do they get a second chance to rebuild that, or do they have to carry that around with them for the rest of their life? Both characters are coming in with very different goals. Ray's coming at it with total shock. He did not expect this to happen. Una seems to be prepared and have some sort of agenda, but Ray doesn't know what that is. And so it scares him.
There's chemistry there, and there's a friendship. That's what drew them to each other in the first place, and that comes out in the show quite a bit as well, and draws on the conflict of what, you know, what their relationship has been, is now, should be. So it's a very, there's a lot of tension in this relationship, but then there's these underpinnings of care and affection that are there.
It's a setting that we're all familiar with, that sort of office space in the break room, and so I'm trying to keep it, you know, very simple and very regular.
The hope is to support the set and try to create a kind of closed-in, claustrophobic feel. We want to go for something that's very, very stark. Like, this is not, like, this isn't a warm conversation that these two are having.
He's just a normal mid-level office management worker. You know, there's nothing special about him. He's not a snappy dresser. And Una is, you know, a well-off-ish 20-something who's, you know, she's more of a creative type. So nothing too absurd.
Sound is our way of bringing the part of the world that they are in to life. There's very real danger. There are very real stakes for these characters about the setting that they are in. The fact that there are other people passing by there at his place of work, that's very significant. They bear themselves completely in front of each other. It's incredibly, it's very raw, and it's very, there's something compelling about it, about the way these two characters are together.
It's a challenging piece, whether it comes to redemption or whether it comes to victims' rights. And I think it's a conversation that we need to continue having as a society.
I think it's one of the most important things that we can talk about. And I think that theater is really important, because watching these people live in front of you, that's when you are able to put yourself in those other shoes.
This show in particular, because of its intimate nature, is going to be a really special and very challenging experience for a lot of audience members.